现在为各位朗读一次本篇重要单字片语。Successful, successful, 成功的。Race, race, 赛跑比赛。Antarctica, Antarctica, 南极洲。Travel, travel, 行进移动。Ahead of, ahead of, 在之前。Diary, diary, 日记日志。现在为各位讲解翻译本篇文章。Englishman Robert Scott, 好，那英国人 Robert Scott is known for, 因为什么而闻名呢？For leading two trips to Antarctica, 他呢带领了两次的旅程呢。来去南极洲啊，也就是带领可能一堆探险队呢去到南极洲两次。The first one made him a star. 那第一次去南极洲让他成为一个明星 ,made him a star. 分到后面呢再加一个句子不需要大写哦。The second, 第二个 the second, 第二次的旅程呢 cost him his life, 就让他葬送了他的生命了，他的代价是他的生命。After his first successful trip, 在他的第一次的成功的旅程之后呢,Scott decided to be the first person, 他决定呢要当第一人。做什么呢 ?To stand on the South Pole, 他想要去当这个第一个站在南极的那么南极的那个点的第一个人。那 however, he wasn't the only one, 他并不是唯一一个人哦，怎样的人呢 ?who had this dream, 有这样子的梦想的人。He would be in a race with the Roald Amundsen, 他呢将会跟这个Roald Amundsen 呢会进行一场竞赛了那他这个人是 from Norway, 是来自于挪威的。Both left their countries by ship, 那两个人都离开他们的国家 by ship, 搭船 in June of 1910, 在1910年的6月离开他们的国家搭船离开 and arrived in Antarctica, 都到达南极洲。In January of 1911, 在1911年的1月到达。About 10 months later, 大概10个月后呢, both teams started their trips. 两者呢,两个队伍呢,都开始他们的旅程。Down to the South Pole, 往下呢,要到南极点的旅程。And their ways of traveling, 然后他们呢,移动行进的方式呢decided which team would win, 就决定了哪一队呢会赢了。Amundsen's team used dogs. 那这个挪威人他使用的是狗 ,and Scott's team used horses. 是那这个英国人 Scott 呢他的队伍则是使用马匹。Because horses weren't good at, 那因为马呢并不擅长于 weren't good at, 擅长于 traveling on snow.并不擅长于在雪上头去行进哦。It took Scott's team 77 days to arrive at the South Pole. 就花了 Scott 的队伍77天才到了南极点。They got there on January 17th, 1912. 他们在1912年的1月17号到达那里。And were surprised to find...然后呢非常惊讶地发现到什么呢 ?That Amundsen was ahead of them. 这个挪威人呢就已经在他们之前啊就到了。The news hit Scott very hard. 那这个消息呢重重的给了 Scott 重重的一击。But what he didn't know, 但他所不知道的是什么呢 ?What he didn't know was, 是 that the worst had not come yet. 最糟的还没来。His team began their long trip home. 他的队伍呢开始他们漫长的回家之旅。 with broken hearts, 带着破碎的心，因为失败了，不是第一个站上南极点的人嘛。After days of terrible weather and little food, 在很多天的很糟糕的天气，以及呢，缺乏食物，几乎没有食物的很多天之后呢， Scott lost his men one after another. 那 Scott 呢，就损失他的人员，一个接着一个。And he himself was the last one. 而他呢，他自己本身呢，就是最后一个 to meet the end of his life. 这是最后一个呢，去这边照字面翻译就是见到他生命的尽头啊，那就是他最后一个走掉，最后一个死亡。No one on his team lived. 在他的队伍没有一个人活着 to go back home, 来回到家 and tell their story, 然后诉说他们的故事。It was only learned through Scott's diary. 那他这个故事呢只被得知啊是经由 through, 经由呢 Scott's diary, Scott 的日记啊才被得知哦。现在为各位慢速朗读一次本文。Englishman Robert Scott is known for leading two trips to Antarctica. The first one made him a star. The second cost him his life. After his first successful trip, Scott decided to be the first person to stand on the South Pole. However, he wasn't the only one who had this dream. He would be in a race with Roald Amundsen from Norway. Both left their countries by ship in June of 1910 and arrived in Antarctica in January of 1911. About 10 months later, both teams started their trips down to the South Pole, and their ways of traveling decided which team would win. Amundsen's team used dogs, and Scott's team used horses, because horses weren't good at traveling on snow. It took Scott's team 77 days to arrive at the South Pole. They got there on January 17th, 1912, and were surprised to find that Amundsen was ahead of them. The news hit Scott very hard. But what he didn't know was that the worst had not come yet. His team began their long trip home with broken hearts. After days of terrible weather and little food, Scott lost his men one after another. And he himself was the last one to meet the end of his life. No one on his team lived to go back home and tell their story. It was only learned through Scott's diary. 现在以正常速度为各位朗读一次本文。Englishman Robert Scott is known for leading two trips to Antarctica. The first one made him a star. The second cost him his life. After his first successful trip, Scott decided to be the first person to stand on the South Pole. However, he wasn't the only one who had this dream. He would be in a race with Roald Amundsen from Norway. Both left their countries by ship in June of 1910 and arrived in Antarctica in January of 1911. About 10 months later, both teams started their trips down to the South Pole, and their ways of traveling decided which team would win. Amundsen's team used dogs, and Scott's team used horses, because horses weren't good at traveling on snow. It took Scott's team 77 days to arrive at the South Pole. They got there on January 17, 1912, and were surprised to find that Amundsen was ahead of them. The news hit Scott very hard, and what he didn't know was that the worst had not come yet. His team began their long trip home with broken hearts. After days of terrible weather and little food, Scott lost his men, one after another, and he himself was the last one to meet the end of his life. No one on his team lived to go back home and tell their story. It was only learned through Scott's diary. 现在为各位讲解三八三九四十四一，这几题克洛兹的题目。第三十八题，第 The first one made him a star. 第一个啊，第一个旅程呢，让他成为明星。那第二个啊，第二个变成什么？怎么样呢 ？Hurt his health， 伤害他的健康 ；Open his eye， 开了眼界 ；Cost him his life， 让他丧失他的生命 ；Made his dream come true。那这一题呢，好，应该是整篇讲完以后，看完之后再来选择。我们先看下第39题。那第39题这个地方 ,however, 然而怎么样呢，那先看下前后文，那后面是 he would be in a race, 他将会跟某某人去做竞争，还有别人，所以这边就可以直接选择他并不是唯一，只有唯一一个有这样子的梦想的人。He wasn't the only one who had this dream. 再来第40题 ,Amundsen's, 他后面是 Amundsen's team used the dogs. 一队呢用狗，一队呢用马。那他后面讲，那所以就是这个使用这个他们的交通工具啊的选择决定了输跟赢啊，所以答案是什么？答案就是猪 and their ways of traveling, 他们移动的方式 decided which team would win, 因为一边有狗一边有马，所以他们就是 their ways of traveling, 因为后面这个要讲 their ways of traveling 嘛，所以答案是猪。再来第41题根据语义最糟的呢他还不知道，因为他们一开始他们现在只是在伤心难过，并不是第一个踏上南极点的人。但是更糟的还没有来哦，就是之后全部人都阵亡了，所以答案是 C, the worst had not come yet。 那因为这一题呢它是死掉所以说我们知道这在第一题的部分呢，我们就知道第38题的部分我们就知道它是 cost him his life 丧失掉他自己的性命了。